we feel the power of God's great hands are felt by some not worthy, while those who sang and praised God's name seem to be passed by. But worthy or not, God loves us all, even a little bird that couldn't fly. Why is life given and taken away too soon for some to tell? And others live for many years and walk a path to hell. A cripple since birth may speak God's name in tender tones with pain, while a man with health and friends and wealth will take God's name in vain. But God's reasons must not be known or questioned by me and you, like the little bird I saw, the bird that never flew. I feel close to each thing that God has made, the earth, the sky, and the sea. And each creature living here belongs to Him, even you and me. And one day while I was walking alone, admiring some of God's beautiful things, by the path on which I walked, I saw a small bird that had no wings. So I sat down, I held out my hand, and that little bird climbed upon. And I held him for a long, long time. I thought maybe that his mama might come. At last he looked at me as though he knew that he'd found him a friend and a home for a bird that never flew. So I built him a little house on the ground like few birds I'm sure have ever known. And he seemed to be so happy there with his new friends and his new home. And for 2 years I fed him and I watched him as with the other birds he'd play. But when they got tired of playing, they'd just fly away. Then a look of loneliness in his eyes as he'd watched the birds fly into the blue. But then a look of understanding as though he knew why he couldn't do that too. And then one summer evening at sunset, I saw a perfect picture of love. Every one of his little playmates were beautiful snow-white dove. And then the ruffle of their feathers as they started into flight. Then I noticed that all the doves but one was white. And he looked like my bird, but he had wings of solid gold and brand new. Then I knew that it was my bird, that little bird that never